Hello. Good morning. Okay, I'm on the job this morning. Welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living Parker in beautiful Parker, Colorado. It is gorgeous today. My name is Felina Harrington. I'm one of the practitioners here. At the Center of Spiritual Living, it is our mission to provide spiritual tools for personal and community transformation. We fulfill with this Sunday gathering by offering classes and workshops and by being of service to both the town of Parker and our community at large and the world. If you are here for the first time, a very special welcome to you. If you are willing to raise your hand, that would be wonderful. So we have a pamphlet for you, and it's coming. Okay. This is a welcome packet. You can just browse through it. Thank you. If you would be so kind, though, to fill out the welcome package and let us know a little bit about you, it allows us to send you the weekly e-newsletter. And that'll keep you informed of what we're doing here at CSL Parker with classes and special events. We plan to have a pet blessing sometime soon, so we'll be announcing that in the future as well. So I'll be offering the interfaith candle lighting, and that'll be Kenny Johnson helping me. And we're going to be lighting, not yet, Kenny, I'm sorry. We'll be lighting the candles today. You can identify practitioners by their white stoles, and we also have a purple stole. Practitioners have gone through 4 years of training, and they see the spiritual truth of any situation, so no matter what is happening in your life, you can sit with a practitioner. We have an area back here. If you would like any kind of prayer and interaction spiritually on what it is that may be interfering with your growth or your today, whatever it is. So now it's time for some more great music for our amazing CSL Parker band, and that's directed by Alicia Archibald.
Surely the presence God is in this place. I can feel the mighty power and the grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence God is in this place. Surely the presence God is in this place. I can feel the mighty power and the grace. Thank you.
Okay, now we will have the candle lighting, and assisting me is Kenny Johnson, who is also a licensed practitioner. At Center for Spiritual Living Parker, we honor all paths to the divine. This candle lighting service highlights 7 of those paths. Our theme for this month is work. We light the first candle to honor Islam. Let the beauty of what you love be what you do. With the second candle is to honor Christianity. The power of one, if fearless and focused, is formidable, but the power of many working together is better. We light the third candle to honor Buddhism. Your work is to discover your work, and then with all your heart to give yourself to it. We light the fourth candle to honor Confucianism. I'm sorry. I can't say that word, really. Choose a job you love, and you will never have to work a day in your life. We light the fifth candle to honor Hinduism. Communication is the real work of leadership. The sixth candle is to honor Judaism. Everything that is really great and inspiring is created by the individual who can labor in freedom. And we light the last and final candle to honor Jainism. The happiest people are givers, not takers. Thank you, Kenny. The reading today is from the book Healing Your Life by Paul Farini. And since I mentioned that this month we're talking about work, this has something to say about it. See how in the past you lived the life that others wanted you to live. In the process, you abandon some of your key interests, some of your passion and gifts. Now is the time for you to follow your heart and embrace your gifts. Forcing yourself to do work that does not honor you or engage your creative passion leads to depression. There will be no energy of joy in your life. There needs to be a relinquishing of this pattern. Your creative energy comes back when you honor yourself and do that which you love. That is what makes you joyful. And then your energy can be expressed with natural enthusiasm and touch the hearts of others. Please join me in an invocation. Mm. The presence of consciousness is here right now. And that presence is known by many names. And it doesn't matter what you call it. God, Spirit, Source, Energy, it's all really the same. This Source, this energy, is light. Precious, precious light. It embodies love, joy, and wants everything to be good for all of its creatures and human beings here on Earth. I am a part of that consciousness, as is all of you. The consciousness, so great, that lives in and through me, has no past, has no present, and has no future, just is, always with us. And I recognize that today we will hear very special words from our guest speaker. And this message will bring many of us, if not all of us, some glimmer of the consciousness of Source, of God. And I recognize that we can all have open hearts. My heart is very open for this message today. And this message can empower us and direct us and live in our soul. And please join me in saying, and so it is. And now we will have some more music.
Good morning. So today's talk title is Failing Forward, and I just have a little bit of comedy for you. It's been a good day. I left my house this morning without my guitar. Now you say, well, then what's that in your hand? Fortunately, Alan was able to communicate via one of those fancy cell phones that we have these days to get the wife to bring the guitar. Yeah.
Thank we were you, set. Catherine.
Yes, thank you very much. Let's see, we were setting up and realized that Richard doesn't have his iPad, so he's using paper today. See, what else happened? Oh, the blessed sign broke this morning. But guess what? We fail forward. The song we're going to sing this morning is by Harold Payne, and it's called Second Chances. And so I think it's very apropos after our morning. Here we go.
Second chances, reflecting on the things I've done. Second chances, knowing that the best is yet to come. Cast a stone out on the endless stream. Possibilities. Watch the ripple flowing, trusting, never knowing where it leads.
second chances, second chances. There's something waiting around the bend. Second chances, second chances. Ready now to take a leap again. All my tears, all my fears subside. All these dreams on bended wings will fly. Second chances, reflecting on the things I've done. Second chances, knowing that the best is yet to come. Cast a stone out on the endless stream of possibility. The river flowing, trusting, never knowing where it leads. All my tears, all my fears subside. All these dreams on bended wings will fly. Second chances, here I go again.
Beautiful. Okay, our guest speaker today is Reverend Jackie Harris. She was born in Pennsylvania and raised in Virginia. I lived there for quite a while. Reverend Jackie came to Colorado in the early 90s. She spent time searching for a church and arrived at a New Thought Center, Mile High Church, in 2006. After taking classes, immediately it led to her to go into the practitioner track, just as some of us here did. And she was licensed as a practitioner in 2011. The call was so strong for Reverend Jackie that she began her ministerial school in 2017 and received her license in January of 2020. She currently is an assistant minister responsible for volunteers and guests at Mile High Church. And her first full year of ministry was online due to COVID. What a bummer. That had to be tough. Reverend Jackie currently lives with her husband and cats in the foothills of West Denver. Her talk today is called Failing Forward. Please welcome Reverend Jackie Harris.
Thank you, Felina. You know, I was thinking, and for those of you that believe in the cosmos hat playing a big part of our life, Mercury is in retrograde. So that supposedly explains all those crazy things that seem to happen to us. But you just have to decide if that works for you. I think that we can always trust that Spirit or God is there in the midst. And it's always kind of fun, I hate to tell you when you left your guitar, it's always kind of fun to take a moment and say, what was that all about? Because there's usually something there for us to learn. And I think that's one of the greatest gifts we have in this teaching, is being able to know that that is possible. So yes, my topic is failing forward. You know, it's kind of an interesting topic. You've been talking about work all month. This is our theme for the year is Living Everyday Wonder. And just to let you know, next month's theme is going to be on finances. So there you go. You ought to get a lot out of that. But I love that Living Everyday Wonder, because I'm a person who believes that as adults, we don't understand wonder as much as we did as children. And so a lot of this talk is going to bring you back to saying, are you willing to look for the wonder in your life and not just get stuck in that habitual routine that we all find ourselves in? So today you've been talking about the good things in work, and today we're going to be talking about something that maybe doesn't sound so good. And by the way, before I go too far, happy birthday, Clyde. So work, really, through this month, you should have been encouraged to look at work as a spiritual practice. Now we're going into a place that you go, how can failure be a spiritual practice? How can it not be? If it's part of our life, then we've got to have learned something from it. And so what you have to do is you have to trust that what you're going through is something that's you're supposed to be going through, and you can come out on the other side stronger and learn something from it. And I'm going to give you a personal experience I've had. As you heard, I'm from the East Coast, and when we moved here to Colorado, I had been teaching high school and community college for years back east, and I loved teaching. But I thought maybe it's time to do something different. So I decided to use my business, because I had a degree in business, use it to actually go into a business and see how that went. So I decided, actually was offered a position in a medical practice, and after about 7 years of doing various things, most of it was the money piece, because that's a lot of the background of a business person, but after about 7 years in various ways of working in this medical practice, I became their practice administrator. And the practice administrator is like I will call it the top dog. If you've ever worked in medicine, that may be an oxymoron. But it's so I was the person responsible for hiring. I was all the pieces. I had to make sure that the money's got in the right place, all of that. And I did that for a total of about 8 years. And in that period of time, I had there were five physicians in this practice, and one of them was a female, and she was really my mentor. About 5 years after I had been in this position, she decided to retire early. And I was then left with the rest of the, and this is so funny, I almost said ministers. And I say that because when I took my first job at Mile High, and they knew I'd come out of medicine, they said, well, you know, ministers and doctors are a lot alike. I thought, oh. But anyway, so that's just one of those little Freudian slips I had. But I want to say that what happened was I felt kind of abandoned, because I didn't feel the support that I'd had having this mentor doctor, because the others just wanted to be doctors. And so there was not a lot of support there. So it was interesting, because after she left and I was feeling some of that struggle, I knew that there was probably something in me that was saying, you need to go to do something else. So about 2-3 years after she had left, I parted ways with this practice, we decided that it would be best for both of us. But the interesting thing to me was, in that little 3-year period of time, I found Science of Mind. And what a gift to have that and be able to move into a new experience and not to feel like a failure, which is so easy to do when it's not really totally, because this job was perfect. It was close to my house, I was making good money, I understood all the ins and outs of it. But down deep, even before Science of Mind, I knew it was no longer fitting me. So I share that story because many of you may have similar stories of thinking you were in the right place and then something happens and it's not the right place. But I was willing to grow and move. And Ernest Holmes talks about this. I'm going to start with a little Ernest Holmes, and I'm going to end with a little Ernest Holmes. And for those of you who aren't familiar, if it's all new to you, Ernest Holmes is the founder of what we call Science of Mind or Religious Science. So from The Power of an Idea, Ernest Holmes said, "Failure does not mean the loss of something. Failure occurs only if the loss of that thing takes our enthusiasm, our courage, our zest for life, our faith, our conviction, and our happiness from us. That is failure indeed." And that's from The Power of an Idea. I'm going to give you some examples, some contemporary examples of people who could have thought of themselves as failing. Think about this, failing forward. So what it is keep moving after the failure. And I'll mention at this point, it was interesting as I was working with this, John Maxwell, who is a leadership consultant in this country, actually wrote a book in 2007 called Failing Forward. And it was all about teams and how you can keep them moving even after they feel that they have failed. But here are some contemporary examples. Michael Jordan missed more than 9,000 shots in his career. He lost almost 300 games. 26 times he was trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. And here's what he says. "I've failed over and over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed." All her life, she wanted to act. She went from being told she was not worth the time it took to train her, to being fired from gigs, and being named Queen of the Bees, the letter B, for her role in second-rate films. Today, Lucille Ball has 2 stars on the Hollywood Walk of Fame and 4 Emmy Awards, just to name a few of her successes. And she had something to say, too, about this. She said, "I'd rather regret the things I've done than the things I haven't." Prior to his presidency, he lost 9 various public offices. He was fired from jobs and went bankrupt as a business owner. Abraham Lincoln was the 16th president of the United States at a very tough time in our nation's history. And he said, "That some achieve great success is proof to all that others can achieve it as well." And all throughout grade school, this person's teacher said he wasn't smart enough and was fired from jobs. After other inventions failed, he persisted on trying again but failed to get any traction on his own inventions. What he is most known for is not for one of his inventions, but an improvement on an existing idea, the light bulb. Thomas Edison took 10,000 tries to get the light bulb right. He said, "Many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. Failing forward. That's only a few. If you're having a tough time and you want to feel better about what's going on, Google. Because I'll tell you, there are so many people we look at as successful who had to dig themselves out when things weren't going well. Don't think that you're in a spot that nobody else has been in. So I'm going to give you three considerations for when you're in a position where you're feeling like you've failed or you're failing. And the first one is redirection. There's a Chinese proverb that says, "Neither let success go to your head or failure to consume your heart." You want to be able to use that everyday wonder as a guide and a companion at all times. I would encourage you to continue to think about that. Is wonder a part of your life? It can help you to move forward. Because, you know, I use this so often in talks. People are probably one day going to say, please, enough. But I love to remind us of children. Watching children, young children particularly, play. They can find wonder if they were to walk out here. I was thinking to myself coming in, I saw the petrified wood out there, and I had thought they were rocks. And I was really curious because I wanted to go up and find out, why is it that hard? And of course, having seen petrified wood on beaches, but it's beautiful. But children would have just walked out there and done what my adult self stopped me from doing, which it says, don't touch. But children will go out in the grass, for example. And if there's a bug or a worm, they get down there and they want to look at it. I don't know that they want to understand it. They're fascinated by it. And as adults, we go, ooh, there's a worm or a bug. We've lost our everyday wonder. And I did we are doing some 10-minute talks now on Wednesday evenings at Mile High. And I did one on your essential self. And it's about the fact that after about the age of 4, we lose that wonder because life moves in. You know, we've got to fit in. We've got to do all those things. But I'm saying to you, we need to grab some of that wonder so we don't feel that despondency, I think, that we can feel at times. So we want to redirect. One of the authors I saw said, remember that failure means there's something else out there. We tend to look at failure as kind of shutting us down. But there's something else out there. So redirect yourself towards the possibilities that are there. Don't get stuck in the failure. And sometimes it may just take a good friend, a family member, somebody to help you through it. And that's a good thing too. Martin Luther King Jr. said, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. So the second consideration when we're talking about failing forward is opportunity. For me, what was so very interesting was I found Science of Mind in that period when I was struggling with what I was doing and not feeling totally supported and all of that. And so what I didn't realize was the opportunity that was there. And it was probably only about 3 months after I had left that practice, I was offered a position at Mile High Church in their accounting department, and I've been there ever since. So that's that's 14 and a half years I've been there. Now, I've been a minister since 2020, but as I said, if I had stayed there, I never would have really seen, I would have missed this opportunity. It doesn't mean that another opportunity wouldn't have come along. So let me say that to you. But be open to what's in front of you. this teaching gives us such an opportunity. And, you know, I can tell you, you know that one of Ernest's favorite sayings was, stay open at the top. And what I say to you is stay open, period. The top is good because you'll, you know, get all those downloads, but keep your eyes open too. There's always something going on around you, whether you really realize that. Failure may mean that there's another opportunity just over the horizon. And Albert Einstein said, out of clutter, find simplicity. From discord, find harmony. In the middle of difficulty lies opportunity. Lots of great wisdom here, folks. And hold on to that wonder. I'm going to really keep hammering on the wonder. And the third one is resilience. You know, Brené Brown writes a lot about resilience, and I'm not even going to quote her today. But the whole idea of failing forward is not letting yourself kind of fall apart. Be kind of tough. Be in integrity, but hold on to that resilience and keep moving forward. Keep moving forward. That's what this whole concept of failing forward is. Not falling forward, failing, moving ahead out of the failure. See if I have any. No. Yeah, as I mentioned to you that John Maxwell wrote the book, Failing Forward. In fact, there's another book out there. There are a couple books called Failing Forward. So I would encourage, if you're interested in that topic, they're out there. But just remember that you don't need a book to tell you to remember that if you hit failure in work or life, other parts of your life, you need to redirect yourself. You need to look for the opportunity that's lying there within whatever just happened, and then be resilient and keep moving. Resilience is really the thing that allows us to fail forward. As I mentioned about wonder, the wonder is part and parcel of that resilience. If you can find wonder in the middle of what's going on in your life, you're going to see how easy resilience is. Because all of a sudden, you've not just taken on whatever has been, you probably feel like whatever's been put on you, but it's going to give you the opportunity to move forward, to keep moving forward, to keep moving forward. Nelson Mandela said, the greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, and you could substitute failing there, but in rising every time we fall. That's what failing forward is talking about. Get up. Be resilient. And I was going to say tough, but I don't want to use tough because that can kind of harden you. What I want to say to you is be resilient. Whatever is coming at you, look at it, look at all parts of it, and then redirect, look for the opportunity, but always stay resilient in whatever you do. This is a great story I'm going to share with you. While competing in the Olympic marathon in Mexico City in 1968, Akwari of Tanzania cramped up due to the city's high altitude. During the race, he fell and severely wounded his knee and dislocated his shoulder. He continued running, finishing last among 17 who completed the race. 79 had started the race. He received a roaring cheer from the few thousand who were left in the stadium, and he was interviewed after he ran, and you know what the question was. Why did you keep running? And he said, and I have trouble every time I even read this, so don't be surprised. He said, my country did not send me 5,000 miles to start the race. They sent me 5,000 miles to finish the race. this is a great story, and you know, it's something that historically lots of people are aware of, but I think it's a great story to remember. Finish the race, whatever that looks like for you. Be willing to go forward and know that success is out there. And success and failure actually are similar to each other, because failure gives you the opportunity for success. Once you see what it is that you can move towards, failure doesn't mean you're done unless you choose to be done. And that is not failing forward. No matter what, keep going. And if a parent, I call it, failure shows up, remember to redirect, see the opportunity, and be resilient. Use wonder and curiosity to be able to frame that for yourself. And from a wise sage, Rumi says, "Yesterday I was clever, so I wanted to change the world. Today I am wise, so I am changing myself." And finally, from our founder, Ernest Holmes, and this is in the Science of Mind textbook. In fact, I kind of smiled. I'm teaching Essential Earnest right now, and this is a quote that happens to come up in Essential Earnest this week. "When things look the worst is the best time to work, the most satisfying time. The person who can throw himself with a complete abandon into that limitless sea of receptivity, having cut loose from all apparent moorings, is the one who will always receive the greatest reward." Let's pray. Spirit of God, it's so clear that everything that is necessary for the life, for a life well lived, is available to each one of us right now. That source, that the divine God, is always providing everything necessary for us to lead an uplifted and fulfilled life all the time, no matter what the circumstances. And I know this for myself, and I know this for each person who hears my voice, that everything is available right now and always. So I know and I affirm for each person here right now that anything that is going on in their life that may appear to be a failure or a misstep or whatever it might be, that each person looks within themselves and says, "Can I redirect? What is a new opportunity?" And then they find the resilience to move on into the next chapter or the next place in life and find success. Because God is a God of success and all good things, no matter what the appearances in this world might reflect. I'm so deeply thankful to know the truth of this prayer, that God is all there is and all there has to be. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Spirit. So now I can release this prayer into that alchemy of love and law, knowing that it is unfolding perfectly now and that the law is always saying yes to what we truly believe. Thank you, God. And so it is.
Second chances. Second chances, reflecting on the things I've done. Second chances, knowing that the best is yet to come. Just a storm out on the endless stream of possibilities. Watch the ripple. Trusting, never knowing where it leads. In all my tears, in all my fears subside. In all these dreams.
chances, second chances. Here I go again.
Well, I'd like to thank again Reverend Jackie Harris for that wonderful, wonderful message and such wisdom. Because as I reflect myself, you know, we probably, many of us have been in the same situation more than once. But it's the faith that you have, and it's the courage that you have. And like you said, you've got to fail forward. So thank you very much. Thank you to our practitioners and our camera operator, Renee Lapine. Special thank you to the amazing CSL Parker band, as usual. So now we're going to have our offering.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. My good is coming to me. My good is coming to me.
I kind of always want to say cha-cha-cha at the end of that song. Okay, so I bless this money that goes out into circulation, that it be delivered to the right people at the right time for enriching our community. And so it is. Now we're going to have Joe Albers give us the announcements.
Thank you, Valina, and good job to her, right? Awesome, yeah. I want to just introduce Shirley here. She's going to give you a quick announcement.
Of course, it's not going to be a quick announcement. It's an exciting announcement. I just wanted to remind you guys that last week, we introduced the Holistic Expo, right? We launched the Holistic Expo last week, and guess what? We already have 60 vendors that signed up for our expo. That is 16% of our projection of 100. It is really, really exciting, guys. And I just wanted to let you know that I attended the BMSC yesterday and on Friday. I tell you, the world is ready for alternative healing and different modalities. People are so excited about the BMSC, and they are also very excited with our show. So Amy and I are working really hard to distribute these flyers, guys. So I need your help. I just wanted to let you know that there's great potential to this expo. We do not charge a lot for our booths. Our tickets are very inexpensive. Like, just to give you an idea, our booths is $150, right? Do you know what the BMSC is charging for a booth? $600, guys. I just wanted to let you know what potential we have with our Holistic Expo. The tickets that we charge is $5. they charge $8, okay? Our projected income for this Holistics Expo, which is a conservative estimate that Amy did, is about $13,000. So we could easily double that, guys. So please, I ask you guys to please participate. Volunteer, please. I do have a list of expos and creative craft shows that we can all attend so we can solicit our vendors and make this really available to everyone. Okay, so they need to know about our expo. And you know that this is definitely good thing for our community, not just for the vendors, not just for our visitors, but our community. It's a great way for us to come together as a group, working together for something that is really going to be a great future for CSL Parker. So please join me. I do have some flyers in here. And if you're interested, we can actually distribute this flyers together. And these are the different craft shows. It's all listed in here up to the end of 2022. We can have fun attending these craft shows, okay? It's really good. So please join. Please, please. Okay, that's it.
Can you feel the energy? Oh my gosh, how do you follow that act? Woo, thank you, Shirley. And thank you too for everyone that's helping out with that. So real quick here, going through, Reverend Stephanie has a Facebook live stream called Tune In, and she has a talks on varying subjects. It's on her Facebook, which is on the CSL Parker website, so you can catch that. And thank you for all of our practitioners that do the meditations in the morning here, and then they're available to talk to afterwards. So thank you. They're the ones wearing the white stoles or other colors, but that's the stuff around their neck, okay? So just brilliance, isn't it? My teachers just loved me in school. Okay, so afterwards we have refreshments over there. Thank you for everybody that brings that, especially the people that make the coffee. Our pet drive, which was supposed to be on the 16th, is being postponed now, so we will let you know when that is offered. The Metaphysical Supper Club is up and running and doing well. Reverend Stephanie has a blog post on her website. Latest topic for September was Oneness is Divine Truth, and she can help with pastoral counseling and creating rituals for your life. Dr. Vern has a new class coming up, which Felina just quoted from the book, and it's called Healing Your Life, using that book by Paul Farini. And those classes, as you all know, are amazing with what they teach you. And that's going to be beginning October the 15th or 19th and 20th on Wednesdays and Thursday mornings at 10 a.m. The offering is $105, and for you new people that are here, if you've never had a class before, you get 50% off. So that's a huge, huge benefit. Let's see here, and we've went through all the rest of this. So I'm going to wrap this up with the saying that the words of the heart are always true. Okay, I'm going to repeat that. The words of the heart, don't trust your mind, but the words of the heart are always true. Listen to them and follow them, and you will always be on the right path of love. Thank you, guys.
Okay. So please join me in a final prayer. I'm so grateful, 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 and thankful that Source never disappoints, never disappoints. The message was right on target. Wise, wise words that we can all take with us. Never give up hope. Especially in yourself. And it has been a privilege to be here with Reverend Harris. a privilege to be here with this wonderful band that supports us and all of the work that goes into this service. I just feel so blessed. So please join me in saying, "And so it is." And now we have a special announcement from Alicia.
So today we celebrate, as you can see over here on this table, a young man. His name is Clyde. Clyde, would you wave to the people? So we're gonna celebrate him after service today. I wanted to just share what was going on back in 1926, a year I'm not familiar with, but music that was out at that time. Duke Ellington, Al Jolson, yeah, that's good stuff. Johnny Marvin, Sophie Tucker. The annual income per year was $1,452. Can you believe that? I'm so glad you made it. I mean, whoa. World population was 2.1 billion. Ford Motor Company announces the creation of a 40-hour work week for factory workers. Thank you very much, Ford. Huh?
Thank you, unions.
Yeah. All that happened, history is amazing. Love just to sit and visit and learn more about our people that have been here for quite a while. And Clyde and Dorothy, we celebrate because they're kind of our founding members here. And we honor you today with a fancy song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Love you. Thanks for being a part of us. Go check out the photos. We have some food, and you all have a blessed week. La da 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 da, 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 la da 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 da. We're a thousand miles from comfort. We have traveled land and sea, but as long as you are with me, there's no place I'd rather be. Same.
place I'd rather be. Be. I'd rather be.